Nimitz has been a symbol of the United States military's might and has been used to project power far from its coastlines. Ford-class supercarriers are being built to replace some of the United States Navy's existing Nimitz-class carriers from 2017. The first ship of this class is the Gerald R. Ford, commissioned July 22nd of this year. It has many key improvements over Nimitz-class, like Electromagnetic Aircraft Launch System and much more onboard power. Russia's 3M-22 Zircon hypersonic cruise missile is expected to enter into production in 2018. The new weapon is capable of speeds of more than Mach 6 and is currently in final stages of testing. The missile is specifically designed to take out high-value targets like aircraft carriers and destroyers. In this video, Defense Updates checks out if USS Gerald R. Ford is capable of defending itself against the Zircon missile. Let's get started.
Number 5.
Zircon missile's weight is 5 tons. It's equipped with a scramjet engine type, which compresses air before it enters the combustion chamber. The scramjet is an innovation of the ramjet, in which the combustion chamber is specifically designed to operate with supersonic airflow. Ramjet engine powers the Indo-Russian BrahMos supersonic cruise missile that can travel at speeds of 2.8 to 3 Mach. Scramjet is simply an acronym for Supersonic Combustion Ramjet. Scramjet-powered Zircon has a speed of Mach 6.2 at a cruising altitude of 30 kilometers. So it's much faster than a bullet fired from a sniper rifle, actually twice the speed of a sniper's bullet. The kinetic energy alone will rip a ship apart like a tin can. The range is about 400 kilometers, though some sources say it could be up to 1,000 kilometers. The Zircon has both radar target seeker and an optical electronic complex to trace and detect targets. The missile can be equipped with a high explosive HE warhead or even a tactical nuclear warhead.
Number 4.
Ford-class carriers, like Nimitz-class, have a layered anti-missile defense system. 1. The RIM-162 Evolved Sea Sparrow Missile, ESSM, is a development of the RIM-7 Sea Sparrow Missile used to protect ships from attacking missiles and aircrafts. ESSM is designed to counter supersonic maneuvering anti-ship missiles. It also has the ability to be quad-packed in the Mark 41 vertical launch system, allowing up to 4 ESSMs to be carried in a single cell. It has a speed of more than 4 Mach and has a range of 50 kilometers. 2. The RIM-116 Rolling Airframe Missile is a small, lightweight, infrared homing surface-to-air missile. It's used primarily as a point defense weapon against anti-ship cruise missiles. The missile has a speed in excess of 2 Mach and has an operational range of 9 kilometers. 3. The Phalanx CIWS is a close-in weapon system for defense against anti-ship missiles. It's intended to provide last-ditch defense when the primary two options have not successfully intercepted the incoming missile. It consists of a radar-guided 20mm Vulcan cannon mounted on a swiveling base. It has a firing rate of 75 rounds per second, a range of 3.5 kilometers, and a muzzle velocity of 1,100 meters per second.
Number 3.
For years, military planners have grouped carriers with other ships armed with missile defense systems, using their own radars and interceptor missiles to protect the massive carriers from existing projectiles. So, at any time, the Ford will have a net of destroyers and/or frigates around it. Also, U.S. Navy carrier groups have airborne warning and control systems, AWACS, that fly ahead to look for potential threats. It's likely that the Zircon will be detected as soon as it's launched. At a distance of 400 kilometers, the carrier group will have only about 3.5 minutes to react. The problem with intercepting will come because none of the current 3 anti-missile defense systems available are meant to destroy hypersonic missiles. These can work against supersonic missiles, though the success rate, even in that case, will depend on many factors. As per most analysts, a swarm attack of 5 to 6 highly maneuvering supersonic BrahMos missiles is expected to saturate the defense, and 1 or 2 is likely to score a hit. In case of Zircon, the chances of penetrating the defenses are much higher owing to the massive speed. Even if the missile is broken up or detonated by close-in weapons, the debris will have so much kinetic energy that the ship may still be badly damaged. There's not been any specific comment from American military about Zircon missile, but sources in Britain have ringed the alarm bell. In March of this year, one senior British naval source said, "Hypersonic missiles are virtually unstoppable." The Royal Navy's Sea Scepter missile defense installed on the latest Queen Elizabeth-class carriers, like the US counterpart, is designed to shoot down missiles traveling at supersonic speeds, not hypersonic speed.
Number 2.
As discussed, the current defense system will be found wanting against Zircon, but US military has already stepped up the game. One of the most important upgrades in Ford class compared to Nimitz class is the available power. Two Bechtel A-1B nuclear reactors are installed in Gerald R. Ford. One of these are capable of producing 300 megawatts of electricity, triple the 100 megawatts of each Nimitz-class reactors. These have been installed so that the Ford class can be equipped with laser guns in coming days. The LAWS, an acronym for Laser Weapon Systems, is currently in testing phase and is expected that in the future, its variants will be installed in US Navy ships. Laser weapons begin with an advantage no other weapon ever invented comes even close to matching. It moves, by definition, at the speed of light. For comparison, that's more than 50,000 times the speed of an incoming missile like Zircon. Laser weapons will be the apt answer for defending against Zircon missiles.
Number 1.
In current state, the Zircon missile is a mighty adversary to the US Navy carrier groups and will potentially make the US carriers stay out of its range. In the future, laser weapons will be able to level the playing field. Stockholm International Peace Research Institute, SIPRI, has recently published its report on military spending of 2016. The US still dominates the space and on a grand scale. The report showed total US military expenditure of $611 billion is over one-third of world military expenditure. This is nearly three times the level of China's spending, which is ranked second, and nine times the spending of Russia. It's clear that Russia cannot match the US platform to platform in military hardware. For example, it cannot build so many aircraft carriers to equal the US carrier fleet. Hence, it's focusing on developing asymmetric warfare capabilities, and Zircon is designed keeping that in mind. As of today, Zircon missile, costing a few million dollars, is technically capable of taking out a newly built $13 billion carrier. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.